Here we can see the Acme Fitness online store, an e-commerce application made by VMware. We use this app for a lot of demos, so you may have seen it in the keynotes or other sessions, and I've set up a separate instance just for our session today. For the demo today, we are going to step into the shoes of a developer at Acme Fitness on the team responsible for this application. Here's the Acme Fitness repo on GitHub, where you can see a diagram of the various services that together make up the online store. I deployed the catalog service on a Amazon EKS cluster, and the remaining components are running on Tanzu Kubernetes Grid on vSphere. We're using a multi-cloud configuration, so we can see how easy that Tanzu can make the developer experience for multi-cluster and multi-cloud applications. Now we've seen the application, let's look how Tanzu application platform is used to bring this app to life. Here, we are looking at Application Accelerators page in the Tanzu Developer Portal. On this page, you can see a selection of accelerators. These are templates that can include all of the base elements and dependencies needed to get started quickly with a wide array of use cases and programming languages. These can easily be customized so your developers not only get up and running quickly, but do so with a code base that is pre-plumbed for your environment and your organizational requirements. For example, the Acme Fitness front-end application is served using Node, so I can use the Node Express accelerator you see here. I can access the template, customize common parameters, and automatically create and populate a Git repository with the initial code base. Accelerators can be accessed by developers using their preferred tools, whether that be through the web portal, or we also have App Accelerator plugins for leading IDEs like VS Code and IntelliJ. And for those who prefer the command line, accelerators can be accessed through the Tanzu CLI. Once a developer is ready to initialize the project, they can enter a single command to deploy the workload directly from their IDE. The first time code is pushed, the platform automatically sets up Git Ops, so that for all ongoing updates, developers working on the project can access the repo, update code, and create pull requests using the same tools and methods they are already comfortable with. And when merged, it will automatically trigger a secure supply chain run. After code is checked in, it needs to go through checkpoints such as build processes, security scans, and approvals. Tanzu's secure supply chain choreographer provides complete visibility through each step so that devs and project team members get self-service, real-time visibility that keeps the code moving forward on the path to production. We can see our supply chain starts when the source provider, which is the workload's Git repository, is updated, and each time the code base is updated, a new supply chain runs, which executes tests, it scans the source code, builds a fresh image, it does an additional vulnerability scan on the container image, where we can see that the SBOMs are easily downloadable. We can see the policy here, where you can customize what action is taken based on your desired criteria. In this case, I configured the supply chain to only block on critical vulnerabilities, and so the scan result passed my defined criteria and was allowed to proceed to the next step. Here we can see that there are a number of additional steps that build all the configuration and other assets needed to then deploy the app to production. The final deliver step shows that the app was successfully deployed. And now that the app is published, we can go to the developer portal catalog to see more details about it. One of the primary ways microservice architectures deliver agility is by breaking applications down into functional components that interact through APIs. This allows them to be developed in parallel, accelerating development while providing a more flexible and modular architecture. But to make this a reality, developers need to have self-service visibility for all the microservices that need to interact with each other. Here we can see the catalog service is designed to provide those details, including who owns the service, relationship graph, documentation, dependency maps, and here on the API tab we can see the API schema is provided and even provides an in-browser client, making it easy for teams to access real-time self-service interactions that provide all the details needed to remove barriers and impediments that can slow down projects. Next, let's look at the Runtime Resources page, which provides developer teams with real-time visibility into the components that are deployed for their application, including their health, memory and resource consumption, performance, and other key metrics commonly needed by developers. Now to recap, we saw how application accelerators can get new projects up and running quickly. we saw how Tanzu Developer Portal made it easy for devs to find all the information needed to interact and integrate with other components through self-service interactions. We saw that developers could easily see the health and the performance metrics for their deployed applications. And now that we've seen how Tanzu empowered the development team to deliver Acme Fitness application, let's explore how the Acme Fitness Ops team is able to operate and support the developer platform and the runtime infrastructure needed to deliver the application.